Welcome again in the ninth lecture of this course module Communication Engineering. So in the last lecture, we have discussed about the envelope detection of the conventional AM signal. So in this today's lecture, we are going to look at what is double sideband suppressed carrier technique. So as we have already seen in the case of conventional AM that the conventional AM is neither bandwidth efficient nor power efficient. As we have seen that the bandwidth requirement for transmitting the modulated conventional AM signal, the bandwidth requirement is twice of that of the maximum signal frequency. Okay. Twice of the maximum, or you can say twice of the bandwidth of the massive signal in the case of multitone signals. Similarly, we have already seen that only 33.33% of the power is being actually used in transmitting the sidebands, okay, which contains the message part, okay, while 67.67% is actually wasted in sending the power itself, okay. So that's why we actually looking at this particular double sideband suppressed carrier scheme. So basically in this scheme, we are going to suppress the carrier part, okay? So basically it is going to give you, it is going to save the power requirement, okay? As we've seen that in the case of AM, the power requirement is very much large. In that case, most of the power is wasted actually in sending the carrier itself. Okay. So today we have to look at how this double sideband suppressed carrier technique can be used and how it is useful in transmitting the massive signal. And again, it can be demodulated. Okay. And while it will be saving the power requirement. Okay. So just try to see this standard time domain expression of the conventional AM signal. Okay. So we have already seen it. Okay. We have already seen this particular expression like it could be written in the form of AC 1 plus then KAMT cos 2 pi FCT outside the bracket. Okay. So if we multiply it, we can write it in this form AC cos 2 pi FCT. Okay. Plus AC KAMT cos 2 pi FCT. So I think you must be aware of this particular equation. Okay. I have written this part for a purpose. Okay. I'm not discussing right now. Okay. I will be discussing it later. So it is the same form, but just for your single tone case. Okay, here it is in the form of MT. Okay, and here it is in the form of single tone massive signal with, we have defined the modulation index mu, which is equals to KA into AM. Okay, so I will be discussing why I have written here it is. Okay, so let me tell you about the time domain expression of the double sideband suppressed carrier. Okay. So as its name suggests, okay, the what is this double sideband? As I said that in the case of conventional AM also, okay, in the case of conventional AM, we have already seen we have the upper sideband and the lower sideband, okay? So it is consists of double sideband, okay? We had double sideband, okay? One is upper sideband and another was the lower sideband, fine? Now what this name suggests, I also told you that the conventional AM signal is also called as double sideband large carrier scheme, okay? So in which we also send a large carrier, okay? Along with the two sidebands, we also send the large carrier. So we can see it from this equation itself, okay? Because it is going to give you, this part is going to give you two sidebands, okay? Upper sideband and lower sideband. And this part is nothing but our large carrier. Fine. So now the name, if you see double sideband suppressed carrier, it means that somehow we have to suppress this carrier. Okay. We have to suppress the carrier. So once we eliminate this carrier, we are going to get the double sideband suppressed carrier modulation scheme. Okay. So obviously what equation we are going to get, we can get AC KAMT cos 2 pi FCT. Or simply if you remove this KA factor, we can simply write MT multiplied with the carrier, okay? So basically we have to multiply the massive signal directly with the carrier, okay? So this is for the time domain expression of the double sideband suppressed carrier, okay? So in which what we are doing is we are multiplying the massive signal MT, okay? This massive signal can be a single tone massive signal or it can be a multi-tone massive signal. So this MT is going to multiply it with the carrier AC cos 2 pi FCT, high frequency sinusoidal carrier. So how this can be obtained? Generally, we will be having a massive signal, which is called as the baseband signal. Okay. And then we are having a circuit. Okay. A circuit that will be able to give you the multiplication between the two. Okay. Carrier and massive signal. So basically, these blocks are generally referred as the product modulator. Okay. You will find in the communication that it is written as product modulator. So why it is called as product modulator? Because the function of this particular block, okay, which is consist of a certain circuitry, is to give you the multiplication of the two incoming signals, right? So it is, we have to apply the carrier and we have to apply the baseband massive signal. So finally, we are going to get a modulated DSBS modulated wave, which is denoted as AC MT cos 2 pi FCT. Fine. Now I will be just discussing a certain case, like MT is a, let us suppose that it is a single tone case. Okay. So in the single tone, we can take this MT equals to AM cos 2 pi FMT. Okay. A massive signal AM cos 2 pi FMT. I hope you must be aware of what is single tone and multi-tone, because I have already discussed in my previous lectures. Okay. So MT is equals to AM cos 2 pi FMT. Now, if we see this MT case, okay, if you apply, means if you put this MT into this standard expression, then we are going to get this expression AC AM cos 2 pi FMT cos 2 pi FCT. Now, simply we have to use the trigonometric formula for cos A and cos B, and then we have to write this particular equation, which is just simply we can write, okay. So which is going to give us AM AC by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FMT, and AM AC by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FMT. Okay. Now you can just compare. Okay. I said that in this expression, okay, you just compare that. I said that this part is going to give you side bends, and this is our large carrier. Okay. So we have just taken this part. Okay. Only factor KA is not there. Okay. We have not included KA because it doesn't matter. Okay. So basically here we are going to get the two side bends. Okay. Here we can see that it is our upper side bend. It is FC plus FM. Okay. Upper side bend. And then we are going to get the lower side bend. Okay. So only upper side bend and lower side bend in this particular time domain expression of DSBS signal is present. Okay. And we do not have this part AC cos 2 pi FCT. So basically what we did is we suppressed this part. Okay. We have suppressed this part. Okay. From our conventional AM signal, we have suppressed the carrier part, and then we are able to obtain DSBSC part. Fine. So carrier is being suppressed in this case. Okay. We have removed it. Right. Now, after having this DSBSC, what we can is do is we can again calculate the Fourier transform of this particular equation. So easily we can, we have already developed the Fourier transform. Okay. So if you calculate the Fourier transform of this equation, it will be two delta functions for each of the terms. Okay. So we are going to get this type of delta functions due to this one. Okay. One delta function will means occur at FC plus FM, and another will be at minus FC plus FM. Okay. So in bracket FC plus FM, and there will be a minus sign. So there will be a mirror image of the delta function. Similarly, another delta function will appear at FC minus FM, and then a minus in bracket FC minus FM. Okay. So these are the different four delta functions that is going to be appear. So that we can look at in the next slide, what will be the its spectrum, frequency spectrum. Before that, we can look at the its time domain waveform, okay, which is very important to understand. Okay. So for example, if we consider this equation, okay, we are just considering this equation, right? So this equation can be used for plotting the waveform of the double sideband suppressed carrier scheme in time domain. So let us suppose that we have this type of massive signal, okay, any arbitrary massive signal MT, which is we have. Okay. So it is not just a single tone case or multi-tone, it can be anything, right? So let us suppose we have this type of massive signal. Okay. So if this massive signal is going to multiply with the fastly varying or a very high frequency carrier signal, okay, sinusoidal carrier, okay, this is our carrier, then obviously the instant amplitude, okay, instant amplitude of this carrier will be based on this. Okay, whatever be the magnitude of this particular massive signal, it is going to multiply with the carrier. Fine. So whatever be the magnitude of this MT, okay, if it is taking 0.25, then the entire amplitude of this cos 2 pi fct will become 0.25 AC. Okay, similarly, if we have taken like AC equals to, suppose that if you take AC equals to 1, then obviously it will become 0.25 when it is reaching up to 1, then this magnitude will also reach up to 1. Okay, then whatever be the magnitude of this massive signal, okay, whatever be the magnitude, considering that AC is equals to 1. So in that case, whatever be the magnitude of this massive signal, the same magnitude this carrier is going to take, okay, its carrier is going to take. Now, one point that we have to make it clear at this point is because here you can see that the massive signal is taking certain positive values. Okay, its magnitude is certain positive values, and again it is also taking certain negative values. So whenever there is a zero crossing, okay, here we can see that because MT is taking a negative value, and when this negative sign is multiplied with the cos 2 pi fct, obviously there will be a phase reversal of the carrier going to take place. Okay, obviously it is having a phase reversal. Okay, so whether the cos 2 pi fct is plus 1 or minus 1, it doesn't matter. If it is plus 1, cos 2 pi fct is plus 1, and MT is taking certain negative value, the entire magnitude will become negative. Okay, it means that there will be a 180 degree phase shift you are going to observe in the output waveform. Okay, it is a point of carrier phase reversal. Remember this point. Okay, so what is the point? Whenever the message is changing its phase, okay, whenever the massive signal is changing its phase and there is a zero crossing, okay, and it is going to be negative, at that time there will be a 180 degree phase change of the carrier signal. It's going to take. Okay, I hope it must be clear. Okay, because when cos 2 pi fct is plus 1 and if it is negative, it will again take the negative value. Okay, cos 2 pi fct will be a negative value. Okay, if it is minus 1 and if it is negative, again it will be making it positive. Okay, so again every time, okay, whenever there is a phase reversal of the massive signal, there will be a 180 degree phase reversal of the carrier, okay, which is going to take place at this particular point. Okay, so that is one of the very basic difference if you compare the time domain waveform with the time domain waveform of conventional AM signal. Okay, please go back to my previous lectures. Okay, and there you try to make a comparison between the like modulated waveform. Okay, in the case of AM signal, you might have observed that there is no phase reversal of the carrier. It's going to take place. Okay, but in the case of double sideband, there will be a 180 degree phase reversal of the carrier. Now, I just want to make one observation here in this particular waveform that if you see this MT, okay, if you see this massive signal that we have plotted, this massive signal is taking positive magnitude as well as the negative magnitude. Okay, so it is the means behavior of the massive signal. It either can be a bipolar or it can be a unipolar. Like it can take either one-sided magnitude like positive or negative, or it can be taking both the magnitudes, positive and negative both. Okay, so here it is like taking positive and negative both. Okay, both the magnitudes are available. Okay, and this is why our this particular signal means the modulated signal is having the phase reversal of the carrier. Okay, because of this. Okay, because of this. Now, if you observe this particular equation of the conventional AM, okay, in the case of single tone modulation, it is easy to observe. As I said that, again, if you see, we are actually multiplying the carrier with the massive signal. Okay, again, we are multiplying the carrier with the massive signal, but there is a term 1 plus mu that you remember. Okay, we have 1 plus and something mu. This is the just one thing that we have to remember. Okay, so what is this mu? We have defined mu as the modulation index. Okay, and we said that the mu maximum value of mu is in the conventional AM should be equals to 1. It cannot be greater than 1. Okay, it cannot be greater than 1. Fine. Otherwise, it will be called as overmodulated signal. Right. So basically, if you see the definition of the modulation index here. We can understand that it is the multiplication of the massive signal with the shifted version of the DC shifted version of the message signal. Okay, this is the carrier signal. AC cos 2 pi f ct. AC cos 2 pi f ct is multiplied with the DC shifted message signal. Okay, DC shifted. Okay, so why is DC shifted? We are saying because we have we have added one quantity is one is added. So what this particular quantity reflects, if you observe it, basically if mu, let us suppose that if we have taken mu equals to let us say 0.5, okay, then you can see that when it is 0.5, okay, and cos 2 pi fmt, the maximum value of the cos 2 pi fmt would be 1 plus 1, okay, maximum value. So whenever it is plus 1, so what is the exact magnitude of this particular entire term? It will be 1 plus 0.5. Okay, so basically our cosine term is taking only 0.5 as a magnitude, means plus 1 as a magnitude, and here we have the modulation index equals to 0.5, and therefore it is becoming 1, means 0.5 multiplied with 1 will become 0.5. okay, and then we are adding 1, so 1 plus 0.5. so what does it mean? Its magnitude was 1, now we are actually adding in this that particular one 0.5 we are adding. Okay, so that the entire magnitude of this is nothing but a DC shifted message signal itself. Okay, and that signal becomes 1.5. its magnitude will becomes 1.5. similarly, if you talk about what will be its minimum point, we are talking about the maximum value of cos 2 pi fmt would be equals to plus 1. Minimum value will be minus 1, right? So when it is minus 1, and when this mu, okay, if we have defined mu equals to 0.5, okay, that time this will become minus 0.5. so what is the minimum amplitude? 1 plus, then again it is minus 0.5. okay, please, I am not able to write here. Okay, so but you can understand that what I am trying to say is when it is minus 1, minus 1 multiplied with 0.5, it will be giving you minus 0.5. so ultimately it is giving you 1 minus 0.5, so it means that its magnitude is 0.5. okay, so though the cos 2 pi fmt, okay, this cos 2 pi fmt is making an excursion between minus 1 to plus 1, okay, but because of this modulation index mu and this DC term 1, okay, 1 plus mu, this entire value 1 plus mu cos 2 pi fmt remains positive. Try to understand this thing. Okay, it is very good observation. Due to the definition of mu and due to this addition of one quantity 1, okay, additional quantity 1, so 1 plus mu cos 2 pi fmt will never be have a value which is less than 0. Okay, you try to observe this. As soon as you can say that under the limit that the mu is maximum value is equals to 1. Okay, if mu is greater than 1, then only this quantity can becomes negative. Try to observe this one. Okay, so basically what we are saying is whenever we have a message signal, so whatever be the message signal negative quantity we have, if we add that much amount of DC, okay, it will be going to be upshifted. Okay, and whenever it is upshifted and if you multiply it with the carrier, okay, it is going to give you conventional AM. This is what I'm trying to say. If you are able to follow me, if you are not, then let me know. Okay, so what I'm saying is if we have added a certain DC quantity to this particular message signal, okay, so that this negative part will also become positive, then there will be no phase reversal of the carrier is going to take place and the scheme will be your conventional AM. Okay, so this is what we have defined here, modulation index. Okay, mu is equals to 1, maximum value is 1. Whenever mu is greater than 1, then this quantity will become negative. Okay, there will be a chances then there this quantity, the entire 1 plus mu cos 2 pi fmt will become negative. And that time it will be treated as a DSBSC signal. It will no more a conventional AM. You try to understand that. If mu is greater than 1, it will be treated as a DSBSC signal. It cannot be your conventional AM. Try to understand this particular thing. Okay, So I hope whatever I'm trying to explain, you must be able to understand. Okay, here we have taken the massive signal and we have not added, we are not giving any offset, DC offset to this massive signal. Okay, and the same message is going to be multiplied with the carrier, and then there will be a phase reversal of the carrier is taking place whenever your message is changing its phase. Fine. So this way we are going to get the double sideband suppressed carrier modulation, and now you can look at the spectrum of this particular DSPS signal. So what is this double sideband suppressed carrier modulation scheme? So if we let us suppose our we have taken our message is equals to AM cos 2 pi FMT, so it will be having this type of a spectrum in which we are going to get two impulse function, one at FM and another at minus FM. Okay, so it is the spectrum of our massive signal. Now from the previous equation of the Fourier transform, we have got the total four delta function. One is at FC plus FM, another at FC minus FM, similarly at minus FC plus FM, and here it is minus FC minus FM. Okay. This is the replica of mirror image of the upper sideband, and this is the mirror image of our lower sideband. The magnitude is remains AM AC upon 4 for all the delta functions. So this is our spectrum, and here we can directly observe from the spectrum itself that there is no delta function at f equals to fc. Okay, this is the basic difference. If you make a comparison with the conventional AM, you will find that there is no frequency component at f equals to fc. Okay, otherwise you would have one more delta function at f equals to fc in the case of conventional AM. But in the case of double sideband suppressed carrier, we are just going to get upper sideband and the lower sideband. Okay. Now, similarly, again, you can calculate the bandwidth requirement of this FM, means DSBSC scheme. So again, it is coming as 2 into FM. Okay. 2 into FM. It means that it is having the same bandwidth as we have in the case of conventional AM. And I said that it is not used for reducing the bandwidth requirement, but rather it is used for reducing the power requirement. Okay, so we can go for the calculation. Okay, of the power. Okay, power requirement. So basically, to know the power requirement of double sideband suppressed carrier. Okay, we have this particular equation. Okay, double sideband suppressed carrier modulation, modulated waves. So here we know that the total power is actually wasted in sending the sidebands only. Okay, upper sideband and lower sideband. Okay, so we have this upper sideband, we have the lower sideband. So the entire power, as I said, that in the case of conventional AM, the total power was equals to PT equals to carrier power PC plus power in the sidebands. Okay, but in this case, we do not have the carrier, and therefore the total power will be wasted in only sending the sideband. So basically, it is the power in the upper sideband and the power in the lower sideband. So now you can see that the PT is equals to AM square AC square by 8, okay, for both the upper sideband and the lower sideband. And ultimately, we are going to get, this is our power requirement, AM square AC square by 4. Now, how to know that there is a, we are able to save the power? Obviously, by calculating the modulation efficiency, okay. So as I said that the modulation efficiency eta is defined as it is power in the sidebands, okay, divided by the total power. Okay, so here it is, you can see that PSB upon PT will be equals to 100%. Okay, so it is giving you 100% power means 100% modulation efficiency means the entire power, okay, is used only for sending the sidebands. Okay, there is no power wastage in sending the carrier, only sending the sidebands, 100% power is being utilized. So that's why it is called as it is modulation, this DSBSC modulation scheme is power efficient. Okay, it is having less power as compared to conventional AM signal. Now we can see again that if it is multi-tone signal, okay, then how this can be means our signal would be, okay, how this modulation will take place and how would be the spectrum. Okay, so in the case of multi-tone signal, we can keep this expression as it is, AC MT cos 2 pi FCT, where we have to assume that the Fourier spectrum of the MT is known, and that is denoted by NF. Okay, the Fourier spectrum of this MT is known, and let us suppose that it is having its spectrum equals to FM, and that spectrum look like something this. Okay, maximum bandwidth is FM, and its magnitude at frequency f equals to zero is known to be M zero. Okay, so this is our multi-tone signal, message signal. So again, if you use the modulation property, okay, I have already explained you. So if you use modulation property, then we will be going to get the Fourier transform equals to AC by 2, M F minus FC and M F plus FC. It means that it is a shifted version of the message spectrum around FC. Okay, it is a shifted version of the message spectrum around carrier frequency FC. So this is our message signal, okay, message signal, Fourier spectrum. So after doing the modulation, we are going to get this type of spectrum. This type of spectrum is going to be appear, okay. So here you can see that again, the same message spectrum is being shifted, okay, around FC, okay. So it will be going to have value, this value will be equals to FC plus FM, the maximum value, and the minimum value will be equals to FC minus FM. So it is FC minus FM. Okay, and this is our central value FC. Okay, so again we have to plot the mirror image. So we have plotted the mirror image. Okay, and now it is AC by 2. Okay, and then this magnitude will be multiplied with the M0, this particular value. Fine, but again you have to make sure that if you see this compare with the conventional AM, you must have remembered that in the case of conventional AM, you would have been you must had one impulse function at this f equals to fc, okay, which is absent in this case, okay, which is absent in this case, it is not present. So in the case of conventional AM, we also had one impulse function at f equals to fc and f equals to minus fc, but in this double sideband suppressed carrier scheme, we do not have that impulse function, okay, so which is suppressed now. So we are sending the upper sideband. This is our upper sideband, and this is our lower sideband. Similarly, here it is upper sideband, and this is our lower sideband. Okay. Now, how to demodulate it? Again, we can go for the synchronous demodulation or coherent detection. Okay. But simply, we have to take this means modulated signal, and then again we have to multiply it with the same carrier cost pi FCT. Okay. As I already explained about the synchronous demodulation. So once you multiply it, okay, we are going to get AC by 2 MT plus MT cos 4 pi FCT. Okay, simply you can get this. It is a very simple equation. Okay, and after that, we can go for calculating the Fourier transform. Okay, again, you can directly see that we are going to get this AC by 2. Okay, AC by 2 MT. Okay, this is our message part, and then this is our it is frequency shifted part of the message. Okay, it is multiplied with the cos 4 pi FCT. Okay, so basically it is a high frequency term. If you directly see it, okay, its frequency is the spectrum of the message signal is shifted around 2 FC. Okay, because it is 4 pi FCT. So if you calculate this Fourier spectrum, you are going to get AC by 2 MF. Okay, then AC by 2 MF minus 2 FC plus MF plus 2 FC. Okay. So this way we are going to get, I hope this, if you calculate it, I hope here it may be a factor 4 will come. Okay, you just check it out, you will be getting a factor 4, because here it is, we are getting AC by 2. So I hope that here you are going to get AC by 4, that you take care. So basically what I'm trying to say is that here is our message signal. So what we have to do is, after multiplying with the same carrier, this signal has to be passed through a low pass filter, okay, of sufficient bandwidth that will be only along the it will only allow the masses part, okay, and high frequency term will be stopped, okay, it will be eliminated, it will be removed by the low pass filter. So this portion will be removed, okay, this portion will be removed, okay, this portion will be removed, only this part will be filtered out, and we are going to get back our original message signal, right? So this is how we can do the demodulation of our multi-tone DSBSC signal. Now, after having this all discussion, again, you can see in this case, if you want to calculate the bandwidth, you are going to get 2 FM, okay, the same bandwidth. So it is clear that the double sideband suppressed carrier scheme is not bandwidth efficient, but it is power efficient. Okay. Now we have to look at how this double sideband suppressed carrier signals can be generated. Okay, we have to see the various generation schemes, right? So that we have to look at. So today I am going to discuss only one, okay, one topic. Then in the next class I will discuss the other topics. Okay. So one of the generation method of the double sideband suppressed carrier modulation is the balanced modulator. It is very simple to understand. What is this balanced modulator, how it can be used, and how it is going to give you the double sideband suppressed carrier signal. Okay, so what we have to take, you just concentrate upon this particular block diagram. Here we can see that we are having an AM modulator. This is nothing but our conventional AM modulator. Okay, conventional AM modulator. So here we can see that in the conventional AM modulator, basically what we have to do is we have to apply the message signal and we have to apply the carrier. Okay, we have to apply the carrier. So once we apply the message signal and then we apply the carrier signal, the output of this particular modulator, okay, the output would be our conventional AM. Okay, so that conventional AM output will be AC 1 plus KA MT cos 2 pi epsilon. Okay, so this will be our output of our upper AM modulator. Okay, then another block here you can see we have 180 degree phase shifter. Fine. So basically, if we have this 180 degree phase shifter, then what we have to perform is we have to phase shift this particular message signal by 180 degree. Okay, so whatever be the MT, if we do it 180 degree phase shift, then we are going to get signal as minus MT. Okay, it is simple to understand. Okay, so basically we have to make a 180 degree phase shift, we are going to get minus MT. And now again in the same AM modulator, we have another AM modulator in which the message signal will be minus 1 MT, minus MT. Okay, and then the same carrier AC cos 2 pi FCT will be applied. So what will be the output of this? Okay, the output of this AM modulator will be AC 1 minus then KA MT. Okay, because MT is now negative, fine. So it will be, the output will be AC 1 minus KA MT cos 2 pi FCD. So if you do this calculation and if you use this particular subtractor, okay, then obviously we will be able to show that the output of the subtractor will be 2 AC KA MT cos 2 pi FCD. It is very simple, okay. This particular term will be cancelled out, carrier part will be cancelled out, and we are going to get YT equals to 2 AC KA MT cos 2 pi FCD. So I hope you must be able to understand this discussion, how this DSP SC signal can be generated using the balanced modulator. Okay, how balanced modulator means, first we have to use the conventional AM modulator, and we have to use the conventional modulator in a balanced form so that the output of the entire circuitry will be our DSBSC signal. Okay, so this way we will be able to generate our DSBSC signal. Now I will be discussing the most prominent method of generating the DSBSC signal, which is a ring modulator. Okay, so I will stop here. In the next lecture, I will be discussing the ring modulator. So please stay connected with the channel for more updates. So thank you for watching. In the next lecture, I will be discussing ring modulator. Thank you.